Hello everyone, and welcome to How-FixIT. If your Switch 2 fan is noisy, the console is running loudly, and you've received an overheating message like, the console is getting too hot and needs to cool down. It's a clear sign that dust buildup is blocking the fan and heatsink. But don't worry, this step-by-step guide will show you how to clean the inside of your Nintendo Switch 2 and replace the thermal paste to restore proper cooling and improve performance. For this repair, you will need a tri-wing and Phillips 1 screwdriver, plastic pry tools, a pair of tweezers, thermal paste, and thermal putty. I'll specify the type later. You will also need isopropyl alcohol and cotton swabs. I've included links to all the necessary tools in the video description below. Before you start disassembling the console, I highly recommend using a magnetic mat. The Nintendo Switch 2 has a lot of small screws of different sizes, and keeping track of them is really important for an easy reassembly process. A magnetic mat helps you organize the screws by sections and prevents them from getting lost, since they stay attached to the mat. It's a simple but very helpful tool when working on compact devices like Switch 2. Okay, let's get started. Make sure to turn off the console completely and remove the Joy-Cons. Lift the kickstand and remove the two screws using a tri-wing screwdriver. Next, remove the two screws near the charging port at the bottom of the console, as well as the single screw located at the top edge of the case. Now, we need to peel off these stickers. To remove them carefully, use a pair of curved tweezers. Start by prying up the sticker from the inner side near the Joy-Con connector. Insert a second pair of tweezers in the small gap and begin peeling the sticker along the edge of the chassis. This is how easily you can remove the stickers without causing any damage. Remove the second sticker using the same method. Remove the two screws located beneath each of the stickers on both sides. Use a plastic spudger to gently pry up the bottom cover. Then, release the latches through the small openings to remove the back cover. Remove the screws securing the antenna modules, then disconnect the antenna wires from the main board before proceeding to remove the metal plate. The thermal putty holds the metal plate slightly in place on this side. Carefully begin lifting it with a plastic spatula. Disconnect the battery cable from the motherboard before proceeding to prevent any short circuits. Remove the four screws securing the heat pipe. The heat pipe in the switch 2 is very thin and must be handled with extreme care during removal. It is hollow and contains a specialized cooling fluid. If bent, it loses its ability to effectively transfer heat to the heatsink. Additionally, the heat pipe is secured with thermal paste and double-sided thermal tape beneath the heatsink. To remove it safely without causing damage, use two plastic spatulas, one on each side, to apply even pressure. Gently lift the heat pipe to loosen it, but do not remove it completely until the heatsink has been fully detached from the double-sided thermal tape. Remove the three screws securing the cooling fan. Open the connector latch, disconnect the fan cable, and remove the fan. Let's start by cleaning the fan and heatsink. Dust or dirt buildup on the fan blades can make their surface rougher, attracting even more debris over time. A clean fan operates more quietly, spins more efficiently, and helps maintain optimal internal temperatures. Ensure the fan is completely clean before reinstallation. Dust accumulation in the heatsink fins can severely block airflow and reduce cooling efficiency. This limits heat dissipation from the processor, leading to thermal throttling or overheating. Use a soft brush to thoroughly clean the heatsink fins. They must be entirely free of dust and obstructions. Once cleaning is done, reinstall the cooling fan into the case. Reconnect the fan cable to the main board and secure the fan using the three designated screws. Next, let's replace the thermal paste. Remove the old thermal paste from the surface of the base plate and the shield plate. If the paste is dried out, use isopropyl alcohol, 91% or higher, and a lint-free cloth or swab to gently clean the surfaces. To access the processor die, you'll need to remove the metal shield plate covering the chip. This shield is secured by small metal tabs around its perimeter. Use a plastic spatula to gently pry under the shield, working your way around the edges to disengage the tabs. With the shield removed, clean off the old thermal paste from both the processor chip surface and the underside of the shield plate. Note that there are tiny SMD components surrounding the silicon. Take great care not to disturb or damage them while cleaning. Use light pressure and precise movements. Once the surfaces are clean, you're ready to apply fresh thermal paste. Apply a small amount of thermal paste, about a rice-sized dot, in the center of the processor chip. Then, using a plastic spatula, gently spread the paste evenly across the entire surface of the chip to ensure full coverage and optimal thermal transfer. For the Switch 2, you can choose thermal paste such as Arctic MX4, Noctua NTH2, or Thermal Grizzly Cryonaut. These pastes offer excellent thermal conductivity and are safe for delicate components. For your convenience, I've included a link in the video description where you can purchase the appropriate thermal paste for your console. If the shield plate was slightly bent during removal, use tweezers to carefully straighten it before reinstalling it on the main board. Ensuring proper contact between the shield and the thermal paste is essential for effective heat dissipation. Since the contact boundaries between the base of the heat pipe and the chip surface are not clearly defined, I recommend applying thermal paste directly to the base plate. This approach ensures full coverage of the heat spreader area. Place the heatsink back on top, making sure it's aligned properly, and screw it back down. Now, let's talk about that pink material between the heatsink and backplate. That's thermal putty, not paste. Unlike standard thermal paste, which works well only in thin layers with tight pressure, thermal putty is designed to fill larger gaps. In the Nintendo Switch 2, there's a significant space, around 1.5 millimeters, between the heat pipe and the backplate. Thermal paste simply isn't thick enough to handle this properly and would lead to poor heat transfer and overheating issues. When selecting a suitable thermal putty, I recommend Thermal Grizzly Putty, which comes in three variants: Basic, Advanced, and Pro, each differing in thermal conductivity, consistency, and price. TG Putty Pro is unnecessary for this application. It is designed for extreme heat transfer scenarios such as servers or high-performance overclocking. Its thermal performance, density, and cost are excessive for a mobile console like the Switch 2. TG Putty Advanced is an excellent compromise between thermal conductivity and ease of application. It performs reliably in the area between the heat pipe and the back cover, where the gap is approximately 1.5 millimeters. It does not leak and remains stable under vibration and heat, making it ideal for this repair. TG Putty Basic is a more budget-friendly option that still performs, particularly if the console is used under moderate load. Visually, its color is very similar to the original thermal putty used in factory-assembled consoles, making it a practical choice for general use. I'm going to use TG Putty Advanced. It has excellent thermal conductivity at around 6.2 watts per meter Kelvin and stays in place without drying out or leaking. It's a perfect replacement for the original thermal putty. Remove the old thermal putty and wipe the surface to eliminate any remaining residue. Then, apply fresh thermal putty and spread it evenly along the heat pipe using the spatula included with the TG Putty. Ensure the layer is smooth and covers the contact surface thoroughly for optimal thermal conductivity. Install the backplate and secure it with the appropriate screws. The applied pressure will evenly distribute the thermal putty, forming the optimal contact layer across the surface of the heat pipe for efficient heat transfer. reattach the back cover, secure it with the screws, and replace the original stickers to complete the assembly. If you found this guide helpful, give us a thumbs up and subscribe for more tech tips and guides. Visit our website for more tech insights and do-it-yourself guides. Remember, every tech challenge is an opportunity to learn and grow. I really appreciate you watching my video guide. Feel free to ask any questions about Nintendo Switch 2 maintenance in the comments. By the way, if you're experiencing issues with your Joy-Cons or Pro Controller, such as analog stick drift or sticky buttons, check out my tutorial on cleaning and restoring your controller. For more details, refer to the helpful links in the video description. Thanks for watching How-FixIT, and see you in the next video.